The Enigma machine, one of the best kept secrets of World War II, both for the Germans and for the Allies. The Germans used this to send encrypted messages from their headquarters to the Army, to the Air Force, and to also the Navy. Now, this one here in front of me is a three-rotor combination, which would give out 150 quintillion possible outcomes, which is just mind-boggling. So, not only do you need to know which rotors to use out of a possible eight, you also need to know which order to put them in, which setting they should be rotated to, and also at the front, what code should be plugged into each outcome here. Each and every time you type a letter, let's use the K for example, you could press K, it will convert it to an L. The next time you press K, it could change it to an A. It was always giving you a different outcome each and every time, making it extremely hard for code breakers to decipher the messages that were being sent. So the Germans would change the code every 24 hours. So code breakers would have to start afresh every day, trying to crack the code, as portrayed in the film Imitation Game. A turning point in World War II was in 1941 when the Royal Navy captured one of these Enigma machines, complete with its eight rotor setting, along with the code book. And then in 1942, they also managed to capture a four rotor one with an updated capture book. The four rotor variation came about because the Germans were extremely concerned that one of these could or had been captured by the Allies, and they were able to crack the code. So by adding a fourth rotor, it increased the possible outcome even more, making it a lot harder for these codes to be broken. Even if the Allies had captured one of these Enigma machines, it really meant nothing to them without that code book. Again, with all of the settings that this item could possibly produce, they needed that code book to help know what code each and every day they need to set this at. This brings me to Bletchley Park and the importance and the significance that the men and women working there played in breaking the code for this. Many of them were mathematicians, scientists, economists, general day-to-day people that had extremely high clearance that worked here day and night trying to crack the code before again it got reset the next morning. Once Bletchley Park was able to crack the code, the intelligence gained from it was invaluable. They were able to read the messages sent from German headquarters and anticipate many troop movement and adjust our own troops to counteract the Germans across Africa, Europe, and the North Atlantic. By knowing the U-boat's movements, America's ships coming from America to Europe with supplies desperately needed to fight the war were able to safely arrive in Europe. By cracking the code, it influenced numerous battles across Europe, including D-Day, one of the most important land invasions to help end World War II. By cracking the Enigma code, it's believed that the war was able to be ended years earlier and saved millions of lives by using the intelligence that was gathered. So even though Germany produced tens of thousands of these Enigma machines, very few survive to this day. It is believed by many experts that there's roughly 300 in private hands and museums. The main cause of that is Germans did not want this to fall into the Allies' hands, so many were destroyed. On the naval boats, they were thrown overboard, and to this day, they've been found at the bottom of the ocean. This important and significant Enigma machine sitting in front of me is extremely complete. It even has the cover for nighttime use that covers the illuminated lights to help dim them. And moving on to the front of the case, it even has the two stamps, original. Basically, this item is a time capsule from World War II. In my many years at Rock Island Auction Company, we have never had the privilege of selling an Enigma machine, which just shows how rare they are and what a significant opportunity this is for a singular item to make its way to your collection. This is a fleeting opportunity to own a unique piece of World War II history that's going to be available at Rock Island Auction Company, Premier Firearms Auction, December 5th through the 7th, with a full day of preview on December 4th. Please feel free to come by and see this, plus many historical and significant items at our Bedford location, Texas. We look forward to seeing you then.